Well after nine, the class standing in line, each one being called by their name. The door hinges squeak, no one dares speak, for Otis is late once again. He's unwatched and crumpled, his clothes worn and crumpled. Nobody's bothered with him. A lifetime of sighs hides in his sad eyes, but he faces the world with a grin. The teacher can guess why he's in such a mess, for his background is well recorded. Home life left to chance while mum's out to dance, through a life drug-fueled and sordid. He's dozing in class as the long mornings pass. The only thing he likes is to model. His hands are so quick, he absorbs every trick. Others fumble. To him it's a doddle. He faces lunchtime with dread. Mum wouldn't get out of bed, so there's only dry bread in his box. He cleans what he can from a food swapping scam, as cunning as any sly fox. He's king amongst kings on the playground swings. He can outrun the others at speed. And all afternoon he's the classroom buffoon, but avoiding his turn when they read. At 3:30, amid giggles and glee, as the children burst out the main door, he hangs on behind, hoping teacher won't mind, as there's nothing to hurry home for. While the parents all wait, cluttered round the school gate, nobody seems to notice. There's no dad or mum to hug this lonely one, for Otis has only got Otis.